I don't know what you think when you hear the name Heather Mills, but from how the media has portrayed Heather, I think a lot of us would think she's hard, she's gold digger, she married a Beatle just for the fame it would bring her, does TV shows like Dancing with the Stars to get more attention.
And think of one thing since you've known me, since I came here 14 years, one thing that I've done that hasn't been for charity. 80% of my money goes to charity. And that's why people want to have a go at me. Because they think, well, that can't be possible. Why would anyone do that? What's the matter with her? Why doesn't she just go and have lunch? So they try and make up articles saying she's gone and spent a million of Paul's money. These crazy things. And all I'd done is gone to see my friend in the hairdressers because they had the logo Giorgio Armani behind. No shopping bags in my hand. Heather's gone on a huge shopping spree. I would never buy from designer stores except Stella's because they use fur. You know,
do you think fighting the press can actually stop some of this now? And this fight, I mean, you can't.
I'm not
take
fighting
on
the
press.
I'm going to the European Parliament. I'm going to change the law like I did with a group of like-minded people, where they have to have responsible journalism. They've pushed so many people over the edge. Extraordinary people that have written to me. Look at Hillsborough. Look at them saying they looted the pockets of the dead bodies when they're trying to find IDs to find out who they are. They urinated, you know, all over them.
But you're taking on such a massive battle.
But
here,
what do you do?
Such a stressful time.
I live in a prison. I live in a prison, right? I have to fight back, otherwise I'll go insane.
All right, and you've got pictures of the sort of stuff you have to go through every day, don't you? With the paparazzi.
That's
which
the only reason I've filmed.
Which about, and there you are in Brighton. And what's going on here, Heather?
Basically, this is over a period of like 6 months. They follow me all the time, and you know, they're trying to hack down my fence. Saying, here he goes, this guy, try to hack down my fence. And they're following me persistently, so I had to let my daughter go out with my friend, and I went out another way. And they've got no licenses. One of the guys in this, the one that I just had convicted for assault, which they thought I wouldn't follow through to the end, he had 132 convictions. 132 convictions, and he's hired with no license. They have to be licensed. Because how do I know when someone's sitting outside my house they're a stalker or not?
So, listen, you say your life's like living in a prison.
It is living in a prison. The only respite that I got was going to America. I did Dancing with the Stars because our money has... Our charity has been so damaged, we needed the money. You know, I was the only person on the show that gave the money to the charity. And then they want to turn that into something awful, like, get lost mucker, says the Sun.
I know. You know, Heather's got a whole file here of cuttings.
I've got 4,000. Not mucker, cha-cha. You're calling me mucker for doing glamour modelling. Do you know what I mean? And they say it's hardcore porn.
Well, listen, you talk about the USA there and you say that was the only light in a very, very small tunnel.
That was the only light that I had.
Would you consider leaving the country? Or
I would live in America in 2 seconds, but I keep my daughter here to be close to her father. I compromise everything. I do. You cannot imagine what I've done to compromise things.
And do you honestly, I mean, you came in here and said you fear for your life and for Beatrice's
life. The police came
life.
Round, and this is why I'm speaking about this now, and I have a box of evidence that is going to a certain person should anything happen to me. So if you top me off, it's still going to go to that certain person, and the truth will come out. There is such a fear from a certain party of the truth coming out that lots of things have been put out and done. So the police came round and they said, you have serious death threats from an underground movement. And I was like, you're joking. And they said, no, they're serious. Here's the 999 number. I never rang the 999 number. I always rang the 08 if there was a 45 number. And then the press write, you know, Heather's crying wolf with 999 calls. The police came to me to tell me I had death threats and that I had to be careful. That means my daughter's life is at risk because she's with me all the time. Could I get security? No. Did I have to go to the bank and borrow it? Yes. It's disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting that I'm put. Who created those death threats? The media, a certain part of the tabloid media, created such a hate campaign against me that they put my life and my daughter's life at risk. And that's why I considered killing myself. Because I thought, if I'm dead, she's safe and she can be with her father. And that is the truth. That's the truth.
All right, Heather.
I'm sick of it.
All right. We'll leave it there. We can see how sick of it you are. I mean, you're really at
and
the
I've
edge.
And I've got nothing to lose.
And have you got friends who are helping you? I mean, how are you getting
through
this?
I have. 300 friends come to my daughter's party. They are biting their tongues not to talk because they're so loyal. Even a journalist said to my publicist, her friends are so loyal, we can't even get them to say a word. Whereas other people's so-called friends are putting stuff out left, right and centre.
Well, thanks for coming in. I hope you feel a bit better now you've got all that off your chest.
I do, and I just hope everyone goes on to uk.com and starts taking responsibility for what we're going to feed our children for the next 20 years. We don't want them to live in a celebrity culture unless that celebrity is going to be used to make a difference in life on the finite amount of seconds we have left on this planet.
All right. Well, thanks for coming in.